Tornadoes are one of nature's most powerful and destructive phenomena. They can appear seemingly out of nowhere, leaving a trail of destruction in their wake. Tornadoes typically develop within an environment characterized by atmospheric instability. This instability arises when warm, moist air at the surface interacts with cooler, drier air in the upper levels of the atmosphere. When these two masses meet, it creates an unstable atmosphere ripe for tornado development. But that's not all. We also need wind shear, a change in wind speed and direction with height. This critical factor sets the stage for the formation of the tornado's rotating column of air. As the thunderstorm intensifies, updrafts of warm air rise rapidly, and the rotating column of air is stretched vertically. This updraft tilts the rotating column to a vertical position, and that's when the magic happens. The spinning column of air starts to condense, drawing moisture from the surrounding storm clouds. As it grows taller and wider, the funnel-shaped vortex takes shape, gradually extending from the cloud base down to the ground. This is the birth of a tornado. Once the tornado is fully formed, its incredible power is unleashed. With winds reaching staggering speeds, sometimes exceeding 300 miles per hour, these swirling giants can uproot trees, demolish buildings, and alter the landscape within seconds. Tornadoes usually form in a special type of thunderstorm called a supercell. Supercells have a spinning updraft of air called a mesocyclone. This spinning motion is important for keeping the storm going and possibly creating a tornado. As the mesocyclone gets stronger, it might create a wall cloud. This is a visible part of the storm that hangs low and rotates like a pendant. When a wall cloud appears, it's a sign that the storm is serious and there's a higher chance of a tornado forming. Inside the fascinating wall cloud, something amazing can happen. A funnel cloud can form. A funnel cloud is a condensed, rotating column of air that doesn't touch the ground yet. It reaches down from the base of the storm and often looks like a long, tapered cloud. It's like a hint that the storm could become even stronger and potentially produce a tornado. When a funnel cloud makes contact with the ground, it officially becomes a tornado. The tornado's strength and size can vary greatly, from weak and short-lived to powerful and long-lasting. The extent of destruction depends on factors like wind speed, size, and duration. Now that we understand the mechanics of tornado formation, it's crucial to stay prepared and vigilant. Tornadoes can strike with little warning, so it's essential to have a plan in place and seek shelter in a sturdy structure or basement during severe weather conditions. Thank you for joining me today as we explored the captivating world of tornadoes. If you found this video informative and exciting, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to join us on our next adventure. Until next time, stay curious and stay safe.